AI content detection seems to only be picking up as AI sweeps the content creation world. And if you just do a simple search for Google detecting AI, you'll see all sorts of companies and blogs reporting about how Google can detect if something is AI generated and is essentially going to flag it as low quality and not show it in the search results. Which makes sense because Google doesn't want people just creating thousands of AI-generated spammy crap articles and ranking them all over in Google. That would be a big mess. So what they've done is they've developed ways to detect the AI content. And there's actually tools that do this now where you can, Originality AI is one. I'll leave a link in the description where you can get access to it. But basically, Google and these tools like Originality AI seems like they're basically using the content generation algorithms on themselves. So we'll just use this ArticleForge as an example. When an AI generation software like ArticleForge writes content, it's using prediction in order to write the content. So we'll give it a keyword like, does Google flag AI content? And then it predicts what it thinks this article should be about based on this term here. So what Google can do is essentially just use prediction models to see if it can predict the content in this article. And that seems to be the same thing these tools are doing over here. It's not as apparent in this tool. There are some other tools where it's more apparent. But if you come over to Originality AI and do a new scan, you can just drop the content in here. It'll also scan for plagiarism, but when you do this, it's going to scan and essentially see if it can predict the words in the content. So if you want to think of it this way, it'll take this first set of few words here and then see if it can predict the rest of the sentence. And if it's able to predict essentially the whole article, then it's AI. And so this one is being detected as 100% AI because it was probably written with GPT-3, which is, I'm pretty sure, what ArticleForge is using. And so it's easy to predict what this content is going to be because GPT-3 is a language model that anyone can tap into and use. And so they can reverse that model and scan this page essentially and figure out, is it AI or is it not? At least to my knowledge, that's what's happening. I'm not 100% sure exactly how any of this AI works because it's kind of crazy stuff. But from what I've seen, there's other tools where it'll do the prediction and then it'll actually show what words that it predicted. And then that relates to the score. So I'm pretty sure that's how they're doing this. But let's do a new scan really quick here with some content from... Well, let's just pull up this first article here and see if they're using AI. So I'll just grab some of their content, scan it. Of course, it's probably not going to pass the plagiarism check because it's on a page that's ranking in Google where it's going to be indexed and probably seen in the plagiarism scan. So it's definitely plagiarized, but you can see that it's original and it's not using AI at all. Well, 3%, but that's it. This might range even if there's no AI used, but essentially this is unique content that was written without AI, even though it's showing that it's plagiarized because we just pulled it from the site. But you can see the difference. The tools that scan for AI content detection don't have any problem noticing that this is definitely generated by AI, which we know it is because this tool uses AI to generate the content. So anyways, I hope you found that helpful. If there's anything you did have questions about in terms of AI content detection or how Google penalizes websites for AI content or anything of that nature, don't hesitate to reach out. You can just drop your questions in the comment section below, and I'll be sure to get back to them there. Look, if you're the type of person that just doesn't even want to deal with your online marketing anymore, and you'd rather just hand it over and have somebody take care of it for you. Or if you really just want to talk to somebody and get some pointers, let's connect. I do offer consulting. I have different services I can offer to help you grow your business through digital marketing. But yeah, feel free to check out my website. You can come on over to TravisWilkie.com. Here's how to spell it because it's kind of funky. But you can come check out some case studies, see the results I've been able to get for my clients over the years. And if you're interested, we can connect. I'd love to help you out. If you can't tell, I love helping business owners grow, especially when it comes to digital marketing. So, all right, I'll talk to you soon. Take care.